Hello and welcome to Prusa Slicer 2.2 update overview. We're going to quickly go over the new features, with the highlights being bundled profiles for third-party printers, hollowing, automatic variable layer height, and adaptive elephant foot compensation. Check the documentation at help.prusa3d.com for a detailed description of all Prusa Slicer features. Let's get started! We've added support for bundled profiles for third-party printers. We'll be working with you, the community, to select and manage profiles for each vendor. In the SLA mode, we've added hollowing with drainage hole generation. Hollowing a model is a great way to reduce resin consumption and internal stress in bigger models. When printing, the first layer is squished against the heated print bed, and as a result, it's usually a bit wider than it should be. The elephant foot compensation is a handy feature, which prevents this from happening by shrinking the first layer a bit. However, previous Prusa Slicer versions would also shrink thin lines, which was a problem. The new adaptive version now properly respects thin lines, but shrinks everything else by the set value. Official Prusa profiles will have this feature turned on by default from now on. The variable layer height can now be calculated automatically, but you can still adjust the height curve manually. If you insert an SD card or USB flash drive, a dedicated button for saving G-codes to removable media will automatically appear, and an eject button. Saved FreeMF project files now have handy thumbnails, which are by the way supported by PrusaPrinters.org. Filament profiles filtering has been added to the configuration wizard. The path planning has been improved and now produces fewer travel moves. The reload from disk function now works even in reopened FreeMF files. This feature is great for cases where you created a newer version of your model and you want to replace the old version in Prusa Slicer without having to set up things like custom supports or modifier meshes all over again. A feature that was heavily requested by the community is inserting a pause at a certain height. That can be used to insert magnets, weights, or nuts into your prints, and you'll get a time estimate till each pause. And in a similar way, you can now insert a custom G-code at a certain height. That's useful for advanced users when creating calibration G-codes like a temperature tower. When adding a color change, you can now pick the color and get an accurate preview. We've added color print for the MMU. This is rather complex, but a simple use case is replacing manual color change with an automatic swap done by the MMU. Speaking of the MMU, we added the option to make the wipe tower without sparse layers, which reduces wasted filament and often the print time as well. You can now set a top and bottom minimum wall thickness, which is especially useful when using the variable layer height function. Sequential printing now follows the order of models in the object list. You can change the order simply by drag and dropping. Plus, by pressing the E key, you can see the object number and name in the 3D view. Prusa Slicer now supports the Space Mouse from 3D Connexion. Basic shapes can now be added directly in the 3D view. And we've added SLA statistics. We now provide builds for Raspberry Pi 4, so you can run Prusa Slicer on the same device as, for example, an Octoprint server. On OS X, we've added support for dark mode, and we've reworked the keyboard shortcuts window. That's still not everything, and if you want to read the full changelog, visit Prusa Slicer's GitHub page. Leave a comment if you have a feature request, and if you want to learn more about any of the existing features, check the documentation at help.prusa3d.com. Happy printing!